Jiff, we're gonna have a clown show today. Does everybody want a clown show?
Yeah!
Great, okay. Let's get set up. Ever seen a clown put on makeup before? Anybody? Okay, a few. Today you get to see a clown put on makeup. We're gonna have a lot of fun.
Yay.
And I'll explain to you a little bit about why clowns put on makeup. First thing clowns do is they put on cold cream. And I'm gonna put my hair out of the way. Looks sort of like a clown already, don't it? Okay. Put a little bit of cold cream on. The reason you do this is because your face is full of holes. Did you know that? Your face is full of holes.
Like a sponge?
They're called pores. Okay? No, not quite like a sponge. And what this does is it builds up the pores so the makeup doesn't. Because if the makeup got down in your pores, then you'd walk around for days with little dots of color in your face. People would think you were really strange.
Huh?
Okay. And besides, what else would be so nice as cold cream on a hot day, right? Okay. Thank you. Okay.
White.
Now we'll put this on. Real careful, okay? Real careful.
You said real carefully and you're doing it hard.
Look kind of like an Indian now, don't you?
Oh yeah.
Big smile? Okay, let's get serious here. All done?
No!
Right here.
Well, right there? Okay, here, I'll get it.
No!
Oh, you can't.
Okay.
On you. Right here.
Right here?
Yeah. You got it.
You were awful eager there. You wanted me to put makeup on you, didn't you?
No.
I want some makeup on.
Yeah. Your mommy might get upset at me. Makeup's not all that easy to get off.
It is when you...
Okay, now. I want to explain to you for a minute why clowns put white on their face. What they do that for is it covers up all their own features. It's kind of like dying a little bit to yourself, because self is under all the makeup. And then as you add colors, a new character comes out. And the character Jiff the Clown. So, now what I want to do is take a powder sock. And I get the powder all over the white. What that does is that allows it set. Won't come off as easy. Won't fall off in my lap. Y'all look white now. Look white? Okay. Now take a nice soft little brush and you brush off the excess powder. Now you're ready for the other colors. Now every clown that puts on makeup has a reason for what he does with his makeup, and I'm no exception. I have a reason for what I put on my face. And every clown's supposed to have a different face. No one's supposed to wear the face of another clown. That's against the rules. Okay? So I want you to see if you can figure out what I'm going to make here with this. What color is that?
Blue.
Right, okay.
Rain.
Rain.
An eyebrow.
A tear.
Okay.
An eyebrow.
Who said a tear? That's right, it's a tear. Okay. Now the reason I put a tear on my face is because it shows the sadness that's in my heart that not every boy and girl has Jesus in their heart. Did you know clowns had emotions? They do. If you go up and kick them, that hurts. If you come up and say, "You're not really a clown," that hurts their feelings. So they can have sadness and their feelings can be hurt. So you want to be nice to clowns, because clowns aren't there to be mean to people. Clowns are there to bring some happiness into your life. Okay, my next color.
Yellow.
What color is
that? Yellow.
See if you can figure out what this is going to be.
Sun. Cheek.
Okay.
Sun.
Okay, we'll see.
A circle. A spot.
We'll see. That's right, it's a circle. Who said circle?
Me.
That's right. So far, it's just a circle, isn't it? Okay, now I'm going to add some stuff to it.
There will be a sun.
You're right, it's going to be a sun. Okay, here we go. Okay, clean the sun. Now, the reason I put a sun on my face is because 15 years ago, that's a long time, isn't it? 15 years ago, I asked Jesus to come live in my heart. And when I did that, he brightened up my life. It was just like the sun shining through the clouds on a real gloomy day. Well, my life was real gloomy. And when I asked Jesus in my heart, he brightened it up, just like the sun coming out. Now, where do clowns always put red?
On their nose.
Here we go. But not all clowns have red lips.
Nope.
Some have to put it outside of their lips and on their lips.
I bet your mama doesn't do that.
Yeah.
I bet she uses a funny little stick. Well, this is grease paint. This isn't makeup like your mother wears. And it doesn't come off near as easy as what your mother puts on either. Oh, we're getting close. We're getting close. Am I starting to look like a clown?
Yeah.
A little bit.
Hair.
Except my hair. Still looks like a hippie, doesn't it? Okay.
You forgot your clothes.
Okay. Okay, now I need powder, my colors. And I'm all done, right?
You forgot your clothes.
Oh, yes. Well, a clown can't go around like this, can he? Some good ad-libbers in here today, don't we? Really ad-libbing a lot. Jiff the Clown. Hi. Hi. Do you always shake that long? Huh? Okay. How many want a clown show?
Yay!
Okay. Let's see what I have in here for some fun. Okay. Now, I want to take a balloon. And you know, everybody always blows a balloon down. They say we're going to blow up the balloon, but they don't. They really start right here, and they blow down the balloon. Well, I'm going to blow up the balloon. Okay? See if I can do it. That's the only way a clown can do it, isn't it? Here we go. Whoop, that was starting down. Here, we'll start up. I'll blow the rest of the way down. Here we go.
That's a long balloon.
Ooh, that's a big balloon, isn't it? Big grin?
A magnet.
Bull.
Magnet.
Oh, yeah, magnet. Here we go. Pick up people. Okay. Now, We're going to do a trick. I need two volunteers.
Me?
Two volunteers. Okay. All right, there in the front row. All right, here, you volunteers. Just stay right where you are. Okay. Now, I want you to hold these for just a second, and then we're going to do another trick, okay? You all hold those. Now, all right. Where'd the balloons go?
My balloon went over there.
My balloon went over there.
Oh, okay. Well, we'll do it with this one. All right, let's disappear. Here we go. All right. Isn't that a big balloon?
Bigger!
And you want to see it get bigger?
Yeah.
Then say bigger. It's isn't it big enough? Whoa, that's pretty big. Okay, here we go. She's a highly trained flea. In fact, this flea is the best shot in Springfield. She can shoot a gun. Oh, really good, okay? And her name is Ann Flea Oak Flea. Ooh, okay. And I have her in here. Okay, everybody want to see her?
Yeah.
Okay, here we go. Oh, there she goes. Oh. Well, it's a good thing I have a good catch, isn't it? Okay, Ann Flea. Let's get to work here. All right. Who'd like to hold Ann Flea when she gets ready to shoot? Okay, little girl in pink here. Come on up. You aren't going to steal my flea, are you? Oh, what's that, Pete? I don't want to lose my fleas. It takes a long time to train fleas. It takes hours and hours and hours. And, I mean, you know, fleas are hard to come by because people are putting flea collars on their dogs and they're dipping their dogs and they're just killing all the fleas. I had to go clear to a flea market to get this flea. That's right. Okay. There we go. You hold her real carefully now. Don't hurt her. Okay. Now, here's Ann Flea's gun. Now, you got to be careful. Gun. Don't ever point guns. Oh, people. I'm sorry about that. Don't ever point guns. Hey, people. Okay. Here we go. Now, you stand right over here, young lady. Okay. Here we go. Now. Alright, now, you get over there, and I'll get, I got a target in here for Ann Flea to shoot at. It's a saltine cracker. I like saltine crackers. Okay, whoop. Don't need to hold in this holder. Okay, here we go. Now, you sit here. Get my holder where I hold the cracker. Must be a thin cracker. Oh yeah, whoa, that's where you're aiming that gun. Okay. Anthony, now when I count to three, Anthony, I want you to fire, okay? Well, no, I'll say ready, aim, and then you do it. Okay, you ready? Good. Ready, aim, fire. Oh, boy, did she ever get that crack. story I want to tell you all.
Okay.
That's a Play-Doh story. How many like Play-Doh?
Me.
Like Play-Doh? I do too. Here we go. I know it's in there. You like Play-Doh?
Yeah.
I do too. The only problem is I can't ever get my Play-Doh out of the can.
Hey, you can't drop
it. Oh, there it is. Oh, okay. Well,
don't get it into the carpet.
Okay, I'll try not to get it in the carpet. Here we go. This is a story of a little old clown named Geppetto. And Geppetto made little things out of Play-Doh. Alright, I need the audience to sit real still, okay? And one day, he was making some stuff out of Play-Doh, and he made a face. Made a little face out of Play-Doh. And he liked that face so well that he decided he'd just keep that little face for a friend. And it kind of turned into a little puppet, and the puppet's name was Play-Dokio. That's right, Play-Dokio. And Geppetto and Play-Dokio were just really close friends, and Play-Dokio always minded Geppetto, always did what Geppetto told him to do. And one day, Play-Dokio was at the park, and he met some guys there that were just not really up to snuff. You know, the kind of guys that do things that aren't quite right. Every once in a while, they try smoking a cigarette to see what it's like. Or if they get one of the older guys to bring a beer, they try drinking beer to see what that's like. And sometimes they steal stuff and lie. Well, Play-Dokio wouldn't dare do any of that stuff because he knew that it would just break Geppetto's heart if he did any of that kind of stuff. But he did like listening to them tell about what they did because it was kind of fun and interesting. And one day, one of these guys came up to Play-Dokio and he said, "Play-Dokio, you're a sissy. You're just a goody-two-shoes kind of turkey. You don't ever do anything wrong." And Play-Dokio said, "Well, that's right. I just really don't even know how to do things wrong." And he said, "Well, we'll help you. We're going to teach you how to lie." So that guy talked to Play-Dokio and told him how to lie. And that night, Play-Dokio went home. And when Play-Dokio went home, Geppetto said, "Play-Dokio, I'd like for you to go take out the trash." And Play-Dokio said, "Oh, yes, I'll do that." He always did what Geppetto asked him to do. So he grabbed the trash, went running out the back door, and he got halfway in the backyard, and he thought, "I think I'll try out what those guys were saying. I think I'll lie. I'll just lie about this." So he hid the trash over in a bush, came back in the house, and Geppetto said, "Play-Dokio, did you take out the trash?" And Play-Dokio went, it was hard for him to lie because he wasn't used to lying. Finally, Play-Dokio said, "Yes, I took out the trash." And he went upstairs to go to bed, and when he went and looked in the mirror, his nose was longer. Oh, no. He was really upset about it. Look at my nose. Look at my nose. Well, he went to bed that night. He got up next morning. He thought maybe it was just an old bad dream, but it wasn't. His nose was still big. He went downstairs. Geppetto didn't notice that his nose had grown. And he asked Play-Dokio, he said, "Would you do me a favor and go upstairs and clean your bedroom? Because we're going to have some company today, and I want your bedroom to look real nice." And Play-Dokio said, "Oh, yes, I'd be glad to." So he ran upstairs. When he got up there, he thought, "Well, you know, I don't want to clean up my bedroom." So he sat down and read a book instead. And after about 20 minutes, he came back down, and Geppetto said, "Play-Dokio, did you clean up your room?" And you know, this time, Play-Dokio said, "Oh yes, I cleaned up my room and it looks real good." It was easier for him to tell a lie the second time. It just came right out of his mouth. But when he said it, his nose started growing and growing, and it wouldn't stop. Oh, no. He ended up looking like Gonzo on the Muppets. In fact, if his ears were just a little bit bigger, he'd have looked like an elephant. Oh, no. And Playdokio was so upset, and even Geppetto noticed this time that his nose had grown. And Playdokio said, "Geppetto, I have a confession to make. I've been telling some lies. And every time I tell a lie, my nose gets bigger. What am I going to do?" Well, Geppetto goes to church all the time, and he knew exactly what to do. He said, "Playdokio, what I want you to do is I want you to just confess to Father God that you've told some lies, and then ask him to forgive you." So Playdokio did that, and when he did, his nose went back down to normal. And listen, everybody listen real carefully. Here's what I want you to remember from this story. The next time you're tempted to tell a lie, the next time that you get ready to say that thing that's not true, remember that your nose is going to grow. Well, your nose isn't going to grow, is it? If that was true, we'd all have noses clear out to here. But you know what happens? The nose of your spirit grows, and your spirit starts to look ugly, just like Playdokio's nose started looking ugly. And the only way to get around that and to cure it is by confessing that you did a sin, that you lied. And then your nose goes back, your spiritual nose goes back, and you start looking nice again like you're supposed to. Okay? Now, I want to sing you two songs, and then we're going to be done. I have a gift for you when we're through.
What's the gift?
I want you to listen real carefully. Real carefully. The words of this song have a lot of meaning. Good. Well, why shouldn't he be? I see it now. I didn't believe God in my heart. So maybe now it's time, and maybe I should ask God to come into my heart. Maybe. You know, 15 years ago, that's a long time, but 15 years ago, I asked Jesus to come in my heart. And when he did, he brightened up my life. And now I can sing this song. Just me and my God, together forever, we're tying a knot. Satan never can sever. I don't need sunshine now to turn my skies to blue. I don't need anything but you. God wrapped me around his word and his finger. He made life a song. He made me a singer. I don't need sunshine now to turn my skies to blue. I don't need anything but you. Yesterday I was sinful.
Say that again.
Yesterday I was sinful. Not now, that was back then. richer than Midas, and nothing at all can ever divide us. Say, don't try tempting me, for I will never nod. I don't need anything. I don't need anything but God. And today, if you've never asked Jesus to come into your heart, I'd like to talk to you about that, because when you have God, you don't need anything else. What we're going to do right now is I'd like for y'all to line up, and I have a gift for you. Everybody line up right there at the set. Okay. And I want to ask you a question when I give you a gift, okay? Here you go. When did you ask Jesus into your heart? Okay, can you remember when you did it? Okay, I want you to stand right over there, okay? When did you ask Jesus into your heart? Today? Amen. Okay. We had vacation Bible school today, so that's right. When did you ask Jesus into your heart? When you were six. Okay. When did you ask Jesus into your heart? Okay. Can you remember exactly what happened when you did it? No? Okay. Stand right over there. Okay. When did you ask Jesus into your heart? When you were eight. You remember what happened? When did you ask Jesus into your heart? When you were seven. What was going on when you were seven that you asked Jesus into your heart? A prayer meeting at your grandmother's house, grandfather's house. Great. Okay, there you go. All right, that's the end of our clown show. Hope you enjoyed it and learned a lot. We'll see you later. Goodbye. Okay, kids, y'all did a good job. Whoops, you want to step in. Appreciate your help.